setting up your first USB microphone and you're feeling a bit lost, by the end of this video, you'll have your Blue Yeti or any USB microphone working perfectly for streaming, podcasting, video calls, or gaming, or whatever it is, in just a few simple steps. Let's dive right in. Hey there, my name is Matthew, and welcome to Test Zone Tutorials, where I help you level up your tech skills one step at a time. Today, I'll show you how to set up the Blue Yeti, one of the most popular beginner microphones, and configure it for streaming in OBS Studio, also free and open source and very, very good. Whether you're using the Yeti or a different microphone, this guide has definitely got you covered. First, connect your Blue Yeti to your computer using the included USB cable. Plug the smaller end into the bottom of the microphone and the larger end into a USB port on your PC. Make sure the mic is securely connected and you'll see a red mute light turn on. A very important part of setting up the microphone is configuring it in Windows. I'm going to right click on the bottom of the screen where the small sound icon is, and I'm going to click on Sound Settings. Once we've done that, you'll see on my computer there's a lot of different options, but scroll past those into the advanced section where it says more sound settings. I'm going to click that. Should open up a small little window that old or longtime Windows users might remember. First thing is to click on the recording tab, the second option, which of course you can see multiple audio sources on my computer. But I scroll down and look for the one that says Yeti Stereo Microphone. Now, it's currently set as the default device, but that's what you want to do. You want to click on that microphone and set default. The second thing that you want to do is go into the properties of that microphone, and I go over to the levels, and as you can see, we've got it at 80%. The reason for that is that you don't want it to be absolutely maxed. We're going to be able to fine-tune that in OBS or other software as well. Before we move on, let's talk about the Blue Yeti's controls. It has a gain knob on the back to adjust how sensitive the microphone is. Start with the gain at about halfway and adjust it as needed. It also has a pattern selector switch to choose your recording mode. So for solo use like this, like streaming or podcasting or whatever, set it to cardioid. That's the little heart-shaped icon, and it's going to work beautifully. Now, let's add the Blue Yeti to OBS Studio. Open OBS and go to the Sources panel, typically near the bottom left. Click the plus button and select Audio Input Capture. Then, I like to name it Blue Yeti or whatever the name of the item is and select it from the device list. To get the best sound, you're going to want to click the gear icon next to your Blue Yeti in the mixer and select Filters. Add noise suppression filter. This is going to just clean up the background noise, PC fan or background noise. It's not perfect, but it makes a big difference in getting the most out of your microphone. If your mic needs a little boost or whatnot, you could also add a gain filter. Play around. There's a lot of other options in here that can be very, very powerful. Test your microphone by speaking into it while watching the audio levels in OBS. Make sure the levels are staying in the green zone without peeking into the red, and you want to adjust the gain knob on the Yeti or whatever settings in OBS with the gain volume just to get it how you like it.
Okay, this is a test of the gain knob on the microphone. It's obviously quite loud. Okay, so this is a test of the gain on the microphone. I have it quite low, but as you can see in OBS, it's set to maximum. I'm going to turn that down a little bit here as I continue to talk, and you're going to see how this makes a massive difference in the overall quality of the sound, and hopefully it's a lot more tolerable for you as well. I like it to sort of just be peeking up into the yellow when you're talking, like in an assertive and happy and really focused way. Otherwise, it can be a little bit overbearing. Let me know what you think here with the noise suppression filter, and we've got the gain down. Might turn it down a little bit. Just depends on you, your voice, and the audio environment that you're working in.
And that's it. Your Blue Yeti or any USB microphone is now ready to go for streaming, podcasting, or gaming. If this video helped you, please give it a like, Subscribe to Test Zone for more beginner-friendly tech tutorials and reviews. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions or want to see more USB mic content. Thank you so much for watching.